Hello, good morning, friends. Today we will be discussing the continuation of the last episode. In the last episode, we discussed one particular area, that is product constancy for doing problems pertaining to inversely proportional quantities, time and speed, and quantity and price, then work efficiency, etc. So today I would like to solve a question which was asked in one of the examinations 2 years back. The question is, I will read the question. On Independence Day, Swedes were decided to distribute equally among 350 students in a school. But on that day, 25 children were absent. Then each child got 5 extra sweets. How many sweets each child got? So we can find a solution by simple an equation stating x is the number of sweets each child got, as our conventional method states. So let us also presume the same. Let us assume that x is the number of sweets each child got. So now there are only 325 students. Each child got x sweets, so x is 325. Easy calculation. X minus 5 is 350. Because 5 sweets they got extra now. So previous x minus 5 is 350. So x into 3, that is 325x is equal to 350x minus 5 into 350. So 350x, that is 25x is equal to 5 into 350. Therefore, x is equal to 5 into 350 by 25. So 5 into 25 is cancel 5. So 70. So answer is 70 sweets. So each child got 70 sweets. That is the correct answer. That is true also, 70. So this we got by writing an equation, assuming that x is the number of sweets each child got. So x is 325 is equivalent to x minus 5 is 350. Answer is 70. So let us view it in another angle, product constancy angle. Here, 25 children were absent on that particular day out of 350. So 25 by 350 is equivalent to 1 by 40. So minus 1 by 40. Why are you only 1 by 40 minus? Because that much students were absent. 25 out of 350, which is equivalent to 1 by 40. So 1 by children were absent. So when children were absent, how much would be the extra sweets? Minus, so we have to minus, it will be equivalent to 1 by 30. Numerator 1, we have to retain as 1. Then 40 minus 130, and we have to give plus sign, because when children less, sweets more. That means 1 by 13 should have, 1 by 13 sweets would be more. This 1 by 13 is equivalent to 5 sweets. Therefore, 1 is equivalent to 13 into 5 is equal to 65 sweets. That means 65 sweets is the total. This is the original as they plan. But now each child got 5 extra. That means 65 plus 5 is 7. So this calculation we can do mentally without even using paper and pen. 1 by 14 is the reduction in the number of children, which is equivalent to increase in the sweets by 1 by 13. And 1 by 13 is equal to 5, therefore 1 is equivalent to 65 sweets. That is the sweet already planned. Now they are getting 5 more, that is 65 plus 5, 70. So we have solved this problem with a different angle, that means using product constancy. Okay, then we will do another problem pertaining to time and distance. Here, Shweta will increase air speed from 24 km per hour to 30 km per hour. She takes 1 hour less than the usual time to cover a distance. Question is, what is the distance usually covered by Shweta? So here also two quantities, one is speed and the other is time. We know speed and time are inversely proportional. So the method product constancy can be applied here also. How? Because she increased her speed from 24 km per hour to 30 km per hour. So how much she increased? 6 km. That means 6 km upon 24. That is 1 by 4. So speed is increased by 1 by 4. Speed is increased by 1 by 4. When it is increased, we have to write 1 by 5. Have you got 1 by 5? Yes, one numerator you have to keep as is, then 4 plus 1, 5. Then we have to have a minus 10, because when speed increases, time decreases. So this is time. So when Shweta increased her speed by 1 by 4, the time is decreased by 1 by 5. And this 1 by 5 time is equal to 1 hour. Therefore, original time is equal to, full time is equal to 5 into 1 is equal to 5 hours. So 1 by 5. 1 by 5 is the reduction in time. When speed increases, time decreases. Speed increases by 1 by 4, time is decreased by 1 by 5, and this 1 by 5 is equivalent to 1 hour. So the total time is equal to 5 hours. We are asked to find the distance. Distance is equal to time into speed is equal to time is 5 hour. We got original. And the original speed was 24. KRPH. So this is 524, 120 km. 120 km is the distance covered by Shweta. So I think this also we'll be able to solve without taking pen and paper using this product constancy method. Hope you understood. Because simply when speed increases plus by 24 to 30, we know it is 1 by 4. When 1 by 4 speed increases, time decreases by 1 by 5. 1 by 5 is equivalent to 1 hour. So 1 is equivalent to 5 hours. So time, total time is 5 hours. 5 hours at the rate of 24 km per hour. So total distance is 120 km per hour. Hope you understood the problem. So by this technique, I think this is not a method. We can use this as a tool. By using this tool, we are able to solve problems with lesser time, even without taking pen or paper. So in usual examination, especially bank examination, you will be getting certain type of problems. And if you continue using this type of tools, you will be able to crack it at the fastest, using maximum, we can save maximum time. That means with the shortest period, we'll be able to solve the problem. So in effect, what we will do is, we'll be able to answer more questions. So allotted time is constant for all candidates. But if a particular candidate is utilizing lesser time, he'll be able to answer maximum number of questions. So he will find a place in the ranking list. Okay, thank you. We'll meet again.